सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रीसतिप्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने ध्याय दक्षिणामूर्तये सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्मादिपूर्वमेताविश्च प्रणोति तस्मै प्रतिबंधस they will discuss as विषयासक्ति ही बुद्धिमान्द्यम एंड देन भेदवादी द्वैत शास्त्र वचन विश्वासश्च इत्यादि ही ज्ञान प्रतिबंधः तथा विलक्षण प्रारब्धम अपि ज्ञान प्रतिबंधकम् एव एंड विलक्षण प्रारब्ध was explained in the tippana or is explained in the tippana janmantara hetu bhuta prarabdha shesha. So some prabala prarabdha is there which runs across janmas that may also present obstacles in the initial of the set of janmas due which will not allow jnana to take place or nishtha to take place even after jnana utpatti. सो ज्ञान प्रतिबंधकमेव प्रतिबंधक सद्भाव दशायां क्रियमाणं ज्ञान साधनीभूतं श्रवणमनादिकं सर्वं प्रतिबंधक निवृत्त्यनन्तरम् एव चिरकाल प्रतिबद्धम् अपि प्रथम जन्म कृतमेव सत् शरीरांतरे ज्ञानम् उत्पादयति. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट ड्यू टू ऑब्स्टैकल्स बीइंग देयर when the obstacles are there pratibandhaka sadbhava dashayam kriyamanam jnana sadhani bhutam although the jnana sadhanas are followed shravana manana ityadi shravana manana nididhyasa sarvam pratibandhaka nivrutyanantaram eva chirakala pratibaddham api prathama janma krutam eva sat shariraantare jnanam utpadayati. So if there are n number of janmas due in one set of prarabdhas, then what happens is that even if the shravana mana nididhyasana is being done in the first janma, second janma, but still it will fructify only in the nth janma when the pratibandhaka nivritti takes place. And in that janma, there need not be any sadhana specifically being done because whatever was the obstacle that goes away, however, shravana manana ityadi which is done in the earlier janmas fructifies now and it appears as though no sadhana is needed for others at least. So prathama janma krutam eva, it has been done earlier and that itself shariraantare jnanam utpadayati tad yatha वामदेवस्य किल ऋषेहे पूर्वजन्मनि कृतश्रवणादेरपि प्रारब्धकर्मफलभूतेनैकेन शरीरेण शेषभूतेन बलवता प्रतिबन्धान् न ज्ञानम् उद्भूतम् श्रवणाद्यनुष्ठानदशायामेव. सो वामदेव वाज़ डूइंग श्रवणादि अनुष्ठान इन दि अर्लियर जन्मास् बट व्हाट हैपेंड पूर्वजन्मनि कृतश्रवणादेरपि ऋषि हु वाज डूइंग श्रवणादि इवन देन प्रारब्ध कर्म फल भूतेन एकेन शरीरेण शेष भूतेन देयर वाज वन शरीर व्हिच वाज ड्यू इन प्रारब्ध देयरफॉर व्हाट हैपेंड बलवता दैट वाज अ प्रबल प्रारब्ध प्रतिबंधात बलवता प्रतिबंधात न ज्ञानम उद्भूतम एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम श्रवणाद्यनुष्ठान दशायमेव न उद्भूतम इट वाज वर्किंग बट देन डिड नॉट कल्मिनेट इनटू ज्ञानोत्पत्ति ही शरीरपातेन शरीरांतर प्राप्ति समये पूर्व जन्म कृतमेव श्रवणादिकं तस्य गर्भे एव ज्ञानं जनयति स्म व्हाट इट डू The Shravana, which was done in the earlier Janma, gave rise to Jnana while Vamadeva was in Garbha. Shariirapatena Shariirantara Prapti Samaye Purva Janma Krutameva Shravanadikam. Not new Shravana. That very Shravana which was done in the earlier Janma, Tasya Vamadevasya Garbhe Eva Jnanam Janayati Sma. Tasmat Jnananantaram Shariirantara Sambandho Naiva Syat. Thereby what? Jnananantaram. Jnana took place in the last of the set of Janmas. Therefore, after Jnanotpatti, there cannot be any Sharira Sambandha. That is Jivan Mukti. So, Vamadeva was free from Sharira in the Garbha itself. When Jnana fructified. Jnaninaha Vartamana Sharira Cheshtatu Prarabdha Karma Dhina Taya Jayate. Then why is there karma? Whatever Vamadeva did, was it his karma or not? That was due to prarabdha karma adhin, dependency on prarabdha karma. The prarabdha was not over. Prarabdha which was blocking the jnanotpatti, that was over. Prarabdha was still there because sharira is still there. Thereby what happened? Prarabdha karma adhinataya. Being dependent on the prarabdha, All karma, sharira cheshta continues to be there. Tatrapi sharira nirvahakatvena yavad akshitam karma tavadeva syat. As much karma is due, only that much will take place. Raga janyadikat yathaishta cheshtadikam naiva syat. However, raga dvesha krita karmas won't be there. Only those which are due circumstantially, those will take place. There won't be any raga, dvesha, ityadi driven karmas because of jnani being krita kritya. Tasma sarva pravritti shunya eva jnani syat. Thereby, sharira sthiti matra karma is what jnani does. Other than that, all pravritti shunya. He remains free from all pravrittis. Ittham Nivritti pradhana eva syad jnanino vyavaharaha. So this is how Nivritti pradhana, jnana. So anyway, atra vama shabdena, this is a tippana, atra vama deva shabdena, rushava deva putro jadabharato api grihyate. So upalakshana jadabharata is also to be understood by vama deva here. Tasya janmatre hetu bhuta prarabdha sheshva avartata. ततः साधन संपत्तौ सत्यामपि न अभूत ज्ञानम् सेम स्टोरी जड़भरत आल्सो हैड लॉट ऑफ प्रारब्ध ड्यू विच लेड टू थ्री मोर जन्मास और टोटल थ्री जन्मास तृतीय जन्मनी अंतरेण एव उपदेशम प्राक अनुष्ठित विचार बलादेव अपरोक्ष ज्ञानम संभवुः So in the case of Jadabharata, in the third Janma itself, Jnana without Sadhana fructified because Sadhana in that Janma. He knew though, he had memory of the earlier Janmas, which is why, if you know of the story, Jadabharata wanted to remain like a Jada. He didn't want to fall into the trap of being attracted to anything else again. And did not want any other Janma. Therefore, what did he do in the last Janma? He focused completely on the Jnana. Whatever was there, he remained mum and kept to himself, lived like a Karika also says, Mandukya Karika, Jadavat Acharet. So this Jadabharata, he was a living example of Jadavat Acharet. But then he, considering that he is just a simpleton, a poor man, the servants of the king called him to carry the chariot. Carry the king's chariot, because they were one man missing. And then he started to jump here and there, trying to avoid ants on the road, which obviously wobbled the chariot, and then people got angry. However, over a period of time, the king came to know that he is a jnani, and then Jadabharata taught him as well. This is a story which occurs in the Bhagavatam Ityadi. So, Tritiye Janmani Antareneva Upadesham. Antarena Upadesham is not to be taken as without Upadesha at all, but there was Upadesha in the earlier Janmas. So, in that last Janma, there was no Upadesha, because earlier Janma Upadesha was there. He was a Kalyanakrit, Yoga Vrashta, but Jnana fructified in the last Janma. Prag Anushthita Vichara Baladeva, Vichara Manana Siddha, it was Aparoksha Jnanam Sambhavuva. Now, Ittham Nivritti Pradhana Eva Sya Jnaninaha Vyavahara. Jnani is focused on giving up Nyasa, Sanyasa, and not taking up additional karma. So, Atra Iyam Ashanka. There is a doubt to this narration, this statement of conclusion. Ittham, in this manner, because it has been explained and established. Now, in this established conclusion, there is a doubt. Manasohi anyata, so manasahi atyanta chanchalmiva svabhavaha tasya cha na niralambanataya sthitihi kshanamatramapi sambhavati. Yat kinchid alambanam ashrityeva manasa sthiti syat. Ataha manasa yat kinchid alambana praptaye jnaninopi pravrutti syat iti. So the doubt is, the mind is a monkey mind. The mind is usually a monkey mind. Even after lot of chitta shuddhi also, it may stick to sadhu vishaya, but it will still not be on one single vishaya. That is the dharma of the mind. It may not go to untoward things, but still it will jump from one thing to the other unless being focused. Only after a lot of sadhana, a lot of samadhi sadhana, the mind remains still. Otherwise the mind is flickery. So here the question is that this mind always needs something or the other to chew on. You can't just sit idle. Physically you can sit idle, but mentally it is not possible to sit idle. The mind will fall asleep. Either it will run around or it will fall asleep. It has no other role. If you try to make it still, it will fall asleep. So it is like the story of that Pishacha, you know. There is a person who comes across a Pishacha, and he says, you take me along, I'll serve you. So this Brahmana who says, okay, I need some help anyway, so why don't you come and do this? So whatever task the Brahmana was giving the Pishacha, he would finish it immediately and ask for another. The condition was that he needs something to do. And his freedom is in that. So what did the Brahmana do? He said that as long as I don't give him work, he'll keep on pestering me. So he said, okay, this is coconut tree. You go and climb up the tree. He immediately climbed up the tree. Said, now you come down. He came down the tree. Now he said, you keep on doing this till I call you. This is your task. So when the Brahmana needed help, he took help from the Pishacha. After that, he said, between the tasks that I give you, your task is to climb up and down the tree. So this is the role of the mind. The mind will want to keep on doing something or the other, it will keep on pestering us, take us for a task unless you give it a task. So meditation is basically giving it a single task. Like climbing up and down the tree, you give it some mantra, it does japa. The idea is not mantra siddhi. Mantra siddhi is also there, but then for sadhaka, mantra siddhi is also a trap. Any siddhi is a trap. Other than brahmatma siddhi, aikya siddhi. So other than advaita siddhi, everything being a trap, mantra is used as a tool so that between the mantra japa, which should preferably be shorter, between any nama japa, what remains is you, Shuddha Chaitanya. Everything else the mind has been withdrawn from, and between two utterances or remembrances of nama, there is Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya, nothing else remains. And the focus is to be shifted from the nama and its artha, padapadartha, to the underlying Chaitanya, which is your own Swarupa. So first you withdraw the mind from everything else, you focus it on the nama, but nama is a tool to land on Chaitanya. It's a stepping stone. Now here what is said is, the mind will keep on jumping here and there. Even for a jnani, it cannot be active without any support. If you don't give any support, it will go to sleep. So manasahi atyanta chanchalyam eva svabhavaha, the jumping monkey mind, tasya cha niralambanataya sthiti kshanamatram api na sambhavati. You cannot have it rest without any alambana, any support. Give it some task. Otherwise, pishachavat. So, yatkinchid alambanam ashritya manasa sthiti syat yataha tataha manasa yatkinchid alambana prapte. Whenever mind finds any support to hang on and stay active, what will happen? It will drag the jnani along. Jnani no api pravrutti syat iti. It will drag the jnani to get involved in some karma or the other, because the mind will bring about some ideas of physical activity also. So whatever is that alambana resulting in the physical activity, the jnani will be dragged to do that. Tatra idam prativachanam. What is the answer to that? Sadhu says, asam asamahita chittasya samadhyanushthana shunyasya chittas samadhana bhavena manasas chanchalyapi samahita chittasya anavaratam samadhim anushtitas tannasyat. Although it is true in the case of everyone, the jnani who practices samadhi is an exception. So one who is samadhi anushthana shunya, then what will happen? Chitta samadhana abhava is there. The composure of the mind is not possible for one who does not have abhyas of samadhi. So what will happen? Manaschanchalya will be there. So the sadhu, the siddhanti is agreeing to the aropa. He says it is true. As a general rule, it is true. But what happens is, if you practice samadhi, then the mind will be trained to be composed even outside samadhi. Therefore, samadhim anushtitaha jnaninaha tanna syat. Tatkim manasaha chanchalyam na syat. Jnani tu samadhau sadasthito bhavati tasman naiva syat kadachid api pravruttir jnaninaha iti. So, jnani practicing samadhi does not get weird ideas as prodded by the mind to act and be outside his sannyasa dharma. So he remains withdrawn. Thereby the topic of samadhi ashtanga is landed upon now. So the 469th avarta says samadhi ashtanga nirupanam. What are these? Ashtanga yoga. Samadhi ashtangani समाध्यंगानि अष्टौ देयर आर एट अंगास यू सीन दीज अर्लियर तानि च यमः नियमः आसनः यमः नियमः आसनं प्राणायामः प्रत्याहार धारणा ध्यानं समाधि सविकल्पकः इति सो यमः दीज आर जस्ट नेम्स वी नो तत्र यमः व्हाट इज यमः अहिंसा सत्यम अस्तेयम् ब्रह्मचर्यम् अपरिग्रह इति पंचविधो यमः सो फाइव यमास आर देयर अहिंसा वी नो नॉन वायलेंस सत्यम वी नो सत्यम इज बेसिकली नॉट स्पीकिंग अनट्रुथ इट इज नॉट दैट एवरी वन शुड स्पीक ट्रुथ अहिंसा सी यमः नियम व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस नियम इज अ रूल like a prescription you do this yamaha is you control yourself from not doing something what is that himsa varjanam ahimsa so one should not do himsa this is what ahimsa means so what does satyam mean satyam does not mean it is control so what does it mean not speaking untruth it is not going out and searching for people and telling them all sorts of truth which they don't want to hear सो सत्यम इज अनृत वर्जनम अस्तेयम नॉट स्टीलिंग सो नॉन स्टीलिंग नॉट टेकिंग समथिंग विच डज नॉट बिलोंग टू यू राइटफुली ब्रह्मचर्यम सेलिबसी मीन्स ऑल्सो निगेशन ऑफ इंडलजेंसेस अपरिग्रह इति पंचविधः यमः सो अपरिग्रह इज नॉट एक्यूमुलेटिंग थिंग्स यू डोंट नीड So these are the broad meanings there. There is a tippana there. We'll come back to tippana later. Niyamaha. So niyama is the second anga. Saucham. So these are prescriptions. Saucham. You should do cleanliness. So it is not that you don't keep things unclean, but here it is you have to clean. So you have to take efforts to clean. Saucham. Santoshaha. So these have meanings which we know tapaha swadhyayaha ishvara pranidhanam iti panchavidaha niyamaha jnana samudrakhye granthe dashavido yamaha dashavido yama niyamascha uktaha in a work called as jnana samudra there 10 yamas and 10 niyamas are mentioned but in yoga shastra 5 each are listed sacha pauraniki reetihi So, Jnana Samudra follows Puranas, and in Puranas there are 10 Yamas and Niyamas discussed. So, it follows that. Vedanta Sampradaya Rityatu Pratyekan Tayov Pancha Panchaiva Vedaha. Yama and Niyama are 5 each. As per whom? So, here we have to be careful. It is not per as per Yogika, as per Vedanta Sampradaya. So people who say in Vedanta Sampradaya there is no place for yoga do not understand Vedanta Sampradaya. Very unfortunate, they throw the baby with the bath water. So Vedanta Sampradaya Ritya, Yama and Niyama are talked about in Yoga Shastra. And here it is being said Vedanta Sampradaya Ritya, there is no Yama Niyama talked about in Vedanta Shastra. Yoga, except for the final conclusion by the people who follow Yoga Sampradaya, by the commentators, etc. We do not agree with the end goal being Dvaita. But Yoga Sutra by itself has Advaita interpretation also, not necessarily only Dvaita interpretation. Thereby, Vedanta Sampradaya Ritya Tu Pratyekam Tayoho Pancha Panchaiva Bhedaha. Vedantins, Sampradayikas, orthodoxy especially follows Yoga Shastra. There is nothing wrong there. In fact, Patanjali Maharshi wrote 3 works. One is Yoga Sutra. There is another work on Ayurveda. And third on Vyakrana called as Mahabhashya. In fact, Mahabhashya style is followed by Bhagavan Bhashyakara as well. Mahabhashya is the original Prasanna Gambhira Bhashya because Bhagavan Bhashyakara follows that style, his Bhashya is also with that depth. So Prasanna Gambhira Bhashya of Bhagavan Bhashyakara is an attribute, a praise, because he follows Mahabhashya. That's why Bhashya, we call everything as Bhashya, but the Vyakrana Bhashya is called as Mahabhashya. So the Yoga Sutra Mula, there is no contradiction there. The last chapter is called as Kaivalya Pada. We are also looking at Kaivalya. Therefore, Vedanta Sampradaya follows Yoga as well. Third Anga is Asanam. Anantaha hi Asana Vedaha Tatra Swastikam Gomukam Viram Kurmam Padmam Kukkutam Utanam Kurmakam Dhanushkam Matsyam Pachimatanam Mayuram Shavam Simham Bhadram Siddham Iti Prakramya Chaturashiti Asanani Yoga Grantheshu Nirupitani. So in Yoga Grantha, basically Hatha Yoga Pradipika. So there are many, 84 asanas talked about, maybe more also, there may be others as well. However, Yoga Sutra says Stiram Sukham Asanam. Any asana that you can sit in easily, steadily for a long duration is called as asana. So others may be needed. I don't even know what all these asanas are. Many of you may be more aware of these, because these asanas are not really so important as long as you land on one. So sahaja asana, the way we culturally, even the way the kids sit, that is sufficient enough, sahaja asana. So Sudarshana asanas, all the swastika, all these are there. There are so many asanas. Siddhasana is supposed to be the best asana, but it is very difficult to land on. It is not easy, and not everyone has adhikara in that asana. So there are so many asanas discussed, but one should stick to whatever one is comfortable with. Tatraiva Tani Tallakshananyapi Vistarasho Jnani. So if you want to know about asanas, you follow those granthas. Wherever yoga granthas describe those, we have no commitment there in asana per se. Tatratu Grantha Vistarabhaya, Tatratu Grantha Vistarabhaya Tesham Vedante Atyanta Upayoga Bhavacha Na Likhyante. They are not useful in Vedanta. Asanas by themselves are not useful. They are necessary for prana to move easily. They are good for maintaining health, improving health. For all these reasons, asanas are needed, but they have no prayojana in Vedanta in the end. And they are quite vast, therefore, grantha vistara bhayat, and has no place in Vedanta per se. Teshu Simham Bhadram Padmam Siddham Iti Chattvari Mukhyani Asanani. So there may be other words also for these. So Padmasana is very well known, difficult to practice. Padmasana, for a continuous time it is difficult to practice unless you have practiced for a long time, but it's a good asana to follow. Tatrapi Siddhasanam Eva. Siddhasana is even better than Padmasana. So Tatrapi Siddhasanam Eva Atyanta Sadhanam. Tallakshanascha ekatra uktam. So the lakshana of Siddhasana is mentioned here. We'll come back to this by looking at the tippana there. Yamadi lakshanam hatayoga pradipikayam patanjara sutre anyatra tatta tippanyadu cha uktam. So the yamadi are also mentioned in hatayoga pradipika, in the yoga sutra, patanjara sutra, and various tippanas there. Rajayoganusaranatu shri Bhagavat Pada Pranita Aparokshanubhuti Granthoktam Prakaram Avalambyatra Kinchil Likhyate. So anyway, we'll come back to this. Since it is talking about Shri Bhagavat Pada Pranita Aparokshanubhuti. Aparokshanubhuti talks about Ashtanga differently. It discusses Yoga Ashtanga and it says, compared to this Ashtangas, we can take different Ashtangas by taking different meanings of each of these asana. So, Yama Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. Different interpretations are given to these words, comparing and contrasting them with the Yoga Sutras Angas. So, we'll look at these after, because this will go across pages. It will talk about all of the Angas in a different fashion. So, we have to know the, although we know it, we'll look at the Mula, what Angas are discussed in. What are the meanings in as per Yoga Sutras? So here Siddhasana Lakshana is mentioned here through verses. I'll just quickly go through it. I'm not going to go through the verse at how to do the Siddhasana. Yonisthanakam Angri Mula Ghatitam Kritva Dridam Vinasyen Medhre Padam Athaikam Meva Hridaye Kritva Hanum Sustiram Sthasnuhu संयमितेन्द्रियः अचलदृशा पश्येद् भ्रूरन्तरं हेतन् मोक्षकपाटभेदजनकं सिद्धासनं प्रोच्यते इति. So there is a way to sit in Siddhasana. This is better learned from a guru. And anyway, in Siddhasana, not everyone has adhikara. In fact, Siddhasana should not be done by women. Very simple. Men should do Siddhasana. Women should not do Siddhasana. This is because the way the where the ankle should be placed, the parts which are mentioned, they are there only in men, they are not in women. There is a different reason for practice of Siddhasana also. Therefore, there is a difference across genders also. It may seem odd, but that's a fact as per the Shastras. So anyway, so where to focus and all that is mentioned in the and it is further described. गुदावृष्णयोर मध्ये वामपादं नियोजये दक्षपादाग्रम भागञ्च वामजंघांतरे न्यसेत् श्यस्तयुग्मं न्यसेद् अंके सिद्धासनं मितीरितं कुंडलीबोधकं शीघ्रं समादेश्च उपकारकम् इति. सो इट हेल्प्स कुंडलिनी एंड आल्सो हेल्प्स समाधि. एंड द रीजन इट शुड बी इन दैट फैशन इज बिकॉज इट फॉर दोज हु प्रैक्टिस Samadhi, rare people, and they go across days also. There, the bodily activities which are natural, they should be stopped. Therefore, bandhas are also fructified by this asana. Tatrayo matantaram. There is another mata also regarding that as to how this should be done. Medhro upari vinyasya. सव्य गुल्फं ततोपरि गुल्फांतरञ्च निक्षिप्य सिद्धासनं इदं भवेत् एतत् सिद्धासनं प्राहुर अन्ये वज्रासनं विदुः मुक्तासनं वदन्त्येके प्राहुर गुप्तासनं परेति. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज सिद्धासन. सम कॉल इट एज वज्रासन. सम कॉल इट एज मुक्तासन. सो देयर इज भेद एज टू व्हिच इज द आसन. द नेम्स वज्रासन हैज अ डिफरेंट मीनिंग आल्सो एल्सवेयर. इट डज नॉट हैव द मीनिंग ऑफ सिद्धासन. मुक्तासन आल्सो हैज अ डिफरेंट मीनिंग. सो इट इज across text described differently. It is described differently across text. So Guptasana also, it is kept a secret as well. So therefore Guptasana. Sampidyas sivinim sukshmam gulphena yuvascha savyataha savyam dakshina gulphena muktasanam itiritam iti nipidyas sivinim sukshmam dakshinetra gulphataha vamam yapyena gulphena muktasanam idam bhavit iti cha idam eva. So we are not really interested in how to practice this pose. So for completion, I read through. Idam eva siddhasanam atyantam pradhanam. Atyantam pradhanam because helps in whatever is needed for a long samadhi, also leads to samadhi. Therefore, kanichid asanani roganashe hetuni, kanichid pranayamadi samadhyanga sadhakani. So some help roganasha. Samasanas help pranayama ityadi. Therefore, idantu siddhasanam. So there is a comparison as to which asana should be done for what and how it is better than others, etc. But idantu siddhasanam samadhi kalo upayogitvad atyantam pradhanam uchyate. It is useful if a person is getting samadhi. In fact, if a person is getting samadhi and kundalini is rising, then this asana will take place automatically even without learning. That is the siddhanta really. So one need not practice the asana, the asana will automatically come out to the person. That is the siddha, siddhi there, siddhasana. Idam eva vajrasanam, but not everyone agrees there. I am just giving my opinion there. Idam eva vajrasanam, muktasanam, guptasanam, ityaneka, anekada ucche. So this is called with different names as well. There also not everyone agrees. Pranayamaha, what is pranayamaha? Asana siddhyanantaram pranayama kartavyaha. Pranayama should be practiced after asana siddhi. Meaning what? Pranayama can be practiced, but pranayama stage itself will only be there after asana siddhi. What is asana siddhi? A person is able to sit in a single asana, not moving around limbs for 45 minutes. This is first asana siddhi. Second asana siddhi is 3 hours. 3 hours if you can sit in one asana as per yoga shastra. Pranayamaha tu aneka vidaha. Pranayamas are also many types, although one gets siddhi in asana, which is a single asana. Pranayamas are manifold. Tathapi tallakshanam sangrena uchyate. What is the lakshana of pranayama, although they are many? Nasikaya vamachidrastha idakhya nadi dvara vayo antarpuranam karyam. Tadeva puraka mityuchyate. Puraka, kumbhaka, rechaka. So you inhale, hold and then exhale, and then there is another stage also. Some texts talk about bahya rechaka, bahya kumbhaka. Some talk about antak kumbhaka. Both are possible. You can hold the breath inside as well as outside, meaning you can remain in exhalation without breath, without breathing. So you may have filled the lungs with prana, or you may have emptied the lungs with prana and still hold on without breathing. So you vamachidrastha idanakhya, so based on the nadi, ida and pingala in the left and right nostril. So you breathe through one nostril and breathe out through the other, breathe in through another and breathe out through the earlier. So you start with the vamachidra and then tadeva purakam ityuchyate. Dakshina, the right nostril, you take the right nostril and open the right nostril and then breathe out. So we all know this. Dakshina nasikasa pingalakhya nadi dvara vayur bahi nissaranam karyam tadeva rechakam ityuchyate. So puraka is inhalation through the left now to start with, then breathing out through the right is called as rechaka. Shushumna dvara vayur nirodhanam karyam. So you tadeva kumbhakam ityuchyate. Basically, when you breathe in and breathe out through one nostril, what you are doing is that you are training the prana to actually enter the shushumna. Shushumna is that nadi where if prana enters, then kundalini follows. That is the reason, not known to many. They just focus on prana, but prana drags along kundalini. That is the idea there. Tadeva kumbhakam ityuchyate. Ittham kriyamananam puraka rechaka kumbhakanam samudayah pranayama ityuchyate. The entire set of three is called as pranayama. Sacha pranayamo dvidha. Eko garbha apara sagarbha. So one is agarbha, another is sagarbha. Garbha is basically with omkara pranava or without. So if one has adhikara in omkara sannyasi, they do pranayama with omkara. Non-sanyasi should do it without omkara. Pranavacharanam vina kriyamana pranayamo garbha. Pranavacharanena saha kriyamana pranayama sagarbha. Pratyahara dharana dhyanani. The last three stages are dharana dhyana samadhi. But samadhi is the end goal. Therefore, earlier three are taken together, which bridge the gap between the bahiranga and antaranga. That is pratyahara. And then dharana dhyana bridges the gap between antaranga sadhana and the end goal samadhi. So swasva vishebhyah sakaleindriya nirodha pratyaharah. Pratyahara is withdrawing all the sense organs from their own vishayas. Nairantariyena antakranasya ekakarata sthitihi dharana. continuously holding on to one vishaya, ekakara, that is called as dharana. Bauhantara ayukta advitiya pratyek brahmani pravahat antakkarana pravahah dhyanam ityuchyate. What is dhyana for a Vedanti? For a yogi, any vishaya is okay for dhyana, but for a Vedanti, the dhyana vishaya is advitiya pratyek brahma. So this is basically nididhyasana, prescribed for a jnani, not an ajnani. An ajnani doing dhyana is not nididhyasana. People call it nididhyasana. I do nididhyasana. Is jnana manana siddha? Are there doubts pending? If doubts are pending, how can one do nididhyasana? So nididhyasana is on pratyek brahma, which is only after the bhagatyaga lakshana is clearly applied on mahavakya and understood without any doubts. Shravana manana stage should be complete. Only viparita bhavana remains, whereby nididhyasana helps take away those obstacles. So antakkarana pravahaha, on the advitiya vishaya, that is called as dhyana here. Samadhi, what is samadhi then for a Vedanti? Vyutthana samskara tiraskarena nirodha samskara prakatanena cha saha antakkaranasya ekagrata parinamaha samadhi. What is samadhi? Ekagrata parinamaha. The vishaya in dhyana, during dharana, landing into dhyana and culminating into not a pravaha, a singular ekagrata. Ekagrata is singular, it cannot be a pravaha, it is not a flow. It is landing on that singular goal and staying there. Ayancha samadhir dvividha. Samadhi is twofold, savikalpaka and nirvikalpaka. So savikalpaka samadhi, nirvikalpaka samadhi cheti. These are Vedanti's words. The yogika words for these are not savikalpaka and nirvikalpaka. Samadhi, people say, has no place in Advaita, in Advaita Vedanta. But savikalpaka, nirvikalpaka samadhi, these words are Vedanti's words. These are not found in Yoga Shastra. Yoga Shastra words are Samprajnata Samadhi, Asamprajnata Samadhi. We may say our Samadhi is different, which is okay. Some say that our Samadhi is different, but then Savikalpaka Samadhi, although said to be different, is a Samadhi. So you cannot say Samadhi has no place, because Vedantins have brought about these terms. We have ourselves brought about these terms. To differentiate, maybe we want to say, no, our Samadhi is not exactly the same as Samprajnata, Asamprajnata Samadhis. So we may say we have a different Samadhi understanding. Many do say. However, to say that there is no place for Samadhi in Vedanta is far-fetched. Jnatrujnana Jnayarupa Triputi Bhana Sahita Advitiya Brahma Vishayaka Antakkarana Vrityavasthitihi Savikalpaka Samadhir Ityuchyate. So vritti avasthiti, samadhi is a pullinga. It is a key pratyanta shabda. It is a pullinga shabda. So here avasthiti is what jnatrujnana jnayarupa. In savikalpaka samadhi there is a triputi. So jnata, jnana and jnaya. Jnaya vishaya, jnata, pramata and jnana as sadhana, which connects them both. So triputi bhana sahita, the triputi is known as being separate. Then what happens? Advitiya brahma vishayaka. The vishaya, jnaya vastu, is advitiya brahma, which is pratyagatma. And that kind of vritti will be there. Antakkarana vritti avasthiti. Antakkarana vritti, where one knows that there is triputi, meaning one knows that I am a meditator on this brahma vishayaka vastu, meaning brahma pratyagatma or brahma vishayaka resultant of mahavakya, And there is a jnana sadhana through which I have understood the meaning of this Mahavakya. Thereby, Savikalpaka Samadhi has Tirputi. Such a Dividaha, that Savikalpaka Samadhi is also Dividaha. This is discussed in Dhridrishya Viveka by Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya. Shabdanu Vidha, Shabda Ananu Vidha Cheti. So, Shabdanu Vidha Savikalpaka Samadhi and Shabda Ananu Vidha Savikalpaka Samadhi. What are those? Aham Brahmasmiti Shabdena Sahita Yaha Sa Shabdanu Vidha. Tad Rahitastu Shabda Ananu Vidha. When the Mahavakya itself is held on to, and one leads one's sadhana through that in samadhi, that Savikalpaka Samadhi is called a Shabdanu Vidha, because it follows the Shabda, Shabda being Mahavakya here. Whereas Shabda Ananu Vidha is where Mahavakya is not where you begin. Triputi Bhana Rahita Khanda, Triputi Bhana Rahita Khanda Brahmakara Antakkarana Vrityavastitihi Nirvikalpaka Samadhi Rityuchyate. However, the Antakkarana Vritti, which is what? Akhanda Brahma Akara. So, once the Triputi resolves and becomes a single Brahma, so the resolution of everything that there is, the Triputi entirely resolves in the Brahma itself, which is non-different from oneself. So, one also resolves in that Brahma, which is the Vishaya on which one is meditating really. Then nothing remains other than Brahmatma. So that is called as Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. Evam Savikalpaka Nirvikalpa Bhedena Samadhir Dvividaha. Tatra Savikalpa Samadhi Sadhanam. Nirvikalpaka Samadhi Phalam. So Nirvikalpaka Samadhi is where one should land on. Therefore, Savikalpaka Samadhi is a means to that. In Savikalpaka Samadhi, also there is Lord of Ananda. Because there is nothing else. You have withdrawn from every other Vishaya. Indriyas are completely withdrawn from the Vishaya. So there is no Vishaya Sukha. The Sukha is from Atma itself. Since there is nothing else, this Brahmatma Jnana, knowing that Brahma is Atma, meaning Atma is Brahma through Otaprota Bhava, if that leads to Samadhi, where Triputi is there, where you know that I am this Brahma, that knowledge is there, you are holding on to that knowledge as a separate entity which you know, and you know that you know you are Brahma, then Savikalpaka Samadhi has taken place, and thereby Brahma being Ananda Swarupa, you have Ananda. However, that Ananda, if one partakes and enjoys as to, let me hold on to this, one craves for it, what happens is that it will deny Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So Nirvikalpaka Samadhi being the goal, where you want to be in the form of Ananda Swarupa and not partake of the reflected Ananda, meaning you don't want to be a subject separate from the Ananda, you want to be one with Ananda. Since this Rasaswada blocks it, even Bhagavan Karikakara says that Rasaswada, if you partake, then it will block the other Samadhi, Nirvikalpaka. Even in Yoga Shastra, it is said Nirvikalpaka Samadhi there, Asampragnata Samadhi is blocked if you start enjoying the Sampragnata Samadhi. Tathapi, Tatra Savikalpaka Samadhi Sadhan Nirvikalpaka Samadhi Phalam. Sadhanatmaka Savikalpaka Samadhu Yajyapi Triputi Rupa Dvaita Pratiti Rasti Tathapi Tad Dvaitam Karana Brahmatmana Eva Pratiyate Na Prathak. So although there is a triad Triputi in Savikalpaka Samadhi, which means Dvaita Bhava is still there, still that Dvaita Brahma, which is separate from you, you are objectifying the Vishaya, Pada at least, where you understand the Padarthra through analysis, and that's how you will finish the manana, dharana, dhyana and landed on samadhi. There, although you know that you are objectifying that ananda, still it is what? Karana Brahma. It is not Karya Brahma. It is not Karya, it is Karana. Therefore, it is not separate. It is not multifold. So you are that Karana. You are not the Karya. You are not enjoying the manifest ananda outside from the world, but you are taking the ananda from the Karana itself. Yatha mrudvikaran mrudrupatvena janato vivekinaha mrudvikaraha ghatadaya mrudrupa eva pratiyante tatha savikalpaka samadho trikuti rupa dvaitam api brahmatmana eva pratiyate. Just like one who has viveka, he looks at all mrutkaryas as what? Mrut, not separately with nama rupa. Similarly, in this samadhi, you don't know this Brahma in different ways, but only as Brahma. Nirvikalpaka samadhav api, savikalpaka samadhav iva, triputi rupam dvaitam vidyamanam api na pratiyate. Although it is there, but being resolved, in nirvikalpaka samadhi, you don't have that pratiti of triputi. Yatha jale nikshipto lavanapindo nilino vidyamano api netrena nagrihyate tadvat. So the resolution state does not mean that it isn't there. It is there in seed form. That's why it comes out again. You cannot have the pramata pop out again if the pramata isn't there at all. So pramata nasha has not taken place. Pramata has become leena in that Brahma, in Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So to the other two in the Triputi. So just like the Chandogya Upanishad, 6th chapter talks about how you cannot find out the salt separately except by tasting the water where you have dissolved salt. Similarly is the state of the Jnani in Samadhi Avastha, where the person in Samadhi Avastha, where he has, in Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, the subject is not separate, he has become one with Brahma. He is there, but as Brahma. So the salt is there as what? Not as salt, as salty water. Salt is also there as salty water. Water is there also as salty water. Tathacha savikalpaka nirvikalpaka samadhyor ayam bheda. What is the difference then? Savikalpaka samadhu brahma swarupena dvaitam pratiyate. Nirvikalpaka samadhu triputi rupam dvaitam na pratiyate iti. So there is no dvaita pratiti of triputi in nirvikalpaka samadhi, whereas it is there in savikalpaka samadhi. This is the only difference as per sadhu here. Sushuptihi nirvikalpaka samadayor bheda. Then isn't it same as sushupti avastha? So this is something that many Vedantis talk about. They say what samadhi? It is same as sushupti. True, it is same as sushupti, but in sushupti you do not know that you know. There is no tool to know. You do not know that you know because there is an avarna of ajnana, but that is not there in samadhi avastha. Huge difference. For everyone, samadhi anubhava is not needed. For moksha, samadhi is not needed. But for that, one should be able to convincingly understand with conviction. One should be having conviction that in sushupti avastha, I am ananda swarupa. Unless one has conviction, it won't work, because sat and chit one will understand in the end, but ananda will be lacking. Therefore, moksha will be of what kind? Nivritta rupa. Many of the Buddhists also have this issue. They practice nivritti up to such an extent, chitta vritti nivritti, and know everything as shunya, including themselves. Therefore there is no ananda. Ananda has to be known as one's own swarupa, which remains even in samadhi avastha. In sushupti, one has to understand that I remain as Ananda. Unless one has that conviction, samadhi cannot be ruled out as mandatory. So, Shushuptau Antakkarana Vrittihi Brahmakaratan Na Prapnuti. In Shushupti, what happens? Antakkarana Vritti does not take place as Brahmakara Vritti. It is Nidrakara Vritti, not Brahmakara Vritti. Kintu Karana Jnana Atmatam Bhajate. Karana Jnana Anandamay Kosha is the Vrittyakara, so Nidrakara. Where there is manifestation of Ananda, but it is veiled. So Ajnana veils, thereby Nirvikalpaka Samadhautu Brahmakarataya Antakkarana Vrittir Vartate Ittham Shushuptau Savrittika Antakkaranasya Abhavaha. So in Shushupti you don't have Brahmakara Vritti, you have Nidrakara Vritti, Ajnanakara Vritti, Karana Ajnanakara Vritti. Nirvikalpak samadhu savrittika antakkaranasya sattvepi na pratitihi. In nirvikalpak samadhi what happens? The antakkarana is savrittika. So this is, there is a difference here. You know, there are various ways in it is explained. So in Sushupti we say there is no vritti. Yoga Shastra talks about nidra vritti. Now here sadhu says in Sushupti there is a vritti. What is that vritti? We say Ananda Vritti is there, but then there is also Ajnana, so Ajnana Vritti is there. This Ajnana itself is Anandamaya Kosha, therefore Ajnana Vritti is Ananda Rupa. So whether you say in Shushupti, no Vritti is there, or it is so Sukshma, it is called as Nidra Vritti, Ajnana Vritti, Anandamaya Kosha Vritti, Karana Ajnana Vritti, they all mean the same thing. Similarly, in Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, if the antakkarana is savrittika, means vritti still continues, that is one way to say that in yoga shastra, yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Whereas in Vedanta, nirvikalpa samadhi has vritti. That is the bheda people talk about. But there are also Vedanta texts which say that in nirvikalpaka samadhi there is no vritti. Nirvikalpaka samadhi is not a yogika term. It is a Vedantin's term. So another way to say is that Nirvikalpaka Samadhi has no vrittis. Why? Because you don't know that it is there. Now not knowing it is there versus saying it is not there have a similar meaning, because in one sense when you say it is not there, you mean it is in a resolved state. When will you know that vritti is there? Only when the Triputi is there. So Triputi Nashat Vritti Nasha Iti Vaktum Api Shakyate. You can say that Vritti isn't there. Therefore, there are, in the same text also, various ways it is expressed that what is this Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. It is not easy to talk about it. So, sometimes the Vritti is explained without Triputi being there, which means Vritti is not known to be there. Meaning it is resolved, or it is so Sukshma, as Sukshma or even Sukshma, then Nidra Vritti, and this is the same meaning that when Chitta Vritti Nirodha is talked about. Nirodha is talked about means not that it is gone. If it is gone, then you cannot come out of it at all. So Yoga Shastra also means the same thing. There is no difference there. One says Nirodha, we issue with that word because we want to separate ourselves out from yogis and say that we are not yogis. We are Vedantins. So there is a compulsion to show that our entire Shastra is completely different. It is not. We have built upon on the strength of all darshanas. We take from all darshanas whatever is right. We don't throw anything out which is useful. So we are actually standing on the shoulders of Sankhya, Yoga, Purva Mimamsakas, Nayayikas, and then we have reached Brahma with Aikya. We surgically remove which is against Advaita, being against Shastras, from each and every darshana, but we don't throw away everything else. We don't need to say that we are totally different. Anyway, at least this is my perspective. Nirvikalpaka samadhu antakkaranasa brahmakara vrityutpattau savikalpaka samadhyabhyasa hetu. So what is said here? Nirvikalpaka samadhu savrittika antakkaranasya sattve api. even if the antakarana which has vritti is there, it is resolved. Na pratitihi, there is no pratiti. Meaning what? If there is no pratiti, how do you say it is there? It is there in resolved state, which is equivalent to saying it is not there. Not there in sense, not manifest. So it, when sushupti also, what do you say? Antakarana isn't there. It doesn't mean antakarana isn't there. It is in a resolved state. It is there. Bijavastha. Similarly, vritti is triputi is not there. It is there in the resolved state. Nirvikalpaka samadhu antakaranasya brahmakara vrittyutpattau savikalpaka samadhyabhyaso hetuhu. So savikalpaka being practiced across a long duration, across days and months, it leads to nirvikalpaka samadhi. Tasmadeva sadhana rupa ashtangeshu savikalpaka samadhi rapi ganyate. Therefore, ashtanga sadhana being talked about, there the ashtanga, the eighth one, the eighth anga is also sadhana because it is savikalpaka samadhi. Being an anga, the eighth cannot be a goal because it is called ashtanga. Therefore, the eighth samadhi is not called as a goal by calling it nirvikalpaka samadhi. It remains as a sadhana, as the eighth anga, by being savikalpaka samadhi. That's why the eighth is interpreted here at least as savikalpaka samadhi. Even Vyasa Bhashya on Yoga Sutra takes it as savikalpaka samadhi because it is sadhana, being ashta anga, angatvat. Anga cannot be the goal. Nirvikalpaka samadhistu tasya phalam. So phala rupa cannot be anga, therefore eighth is also savikalpaka samadhi, not nirvikalpa. Nirvikalpaka. So nirvikalpaka samadhir dvaividhyam. So we'll look at this after we look at the tippana as to what does Bhagavan Bhashyakara or Bhagavat Padacharya say in Aparokshanubhuti as to the angas of yoga, ashtanga yoga, what is the reinterpretation of those. We'll stop here. Sukham Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakam Nama Rupya Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Durkyatam Param Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Brahma Tadeva Annamattva Nirti Menishchitamati. Namaste.